The radiation pressure from the sun is responsible for cleaning out the inner solar system of small particles. In the first part of the question, the force of radiation on spherical particle of radius r is given by F is equal to P Q pi r square, where P is the radiation pressure and Q is the dimensionless quality factor that depends on the relative size of particle, and this r stands for the radius or the factor corresponding to the size of the particle, and the wavelength of the light lambda. Throughout the problem, assume that the sun emits a single wavelength lambda maximum. Unless told otherwise, leave your answer in terms of symbolic variables. Clear? Now this question is basically related to the concept of radiation pressure. Means here we have to concentrate on the particle nature of light. Particle nature of light means when photon hits a surface, they will transfer momentum to that particular surface. And here we are assuming that the photons, when hit to the surface, they will not rebound and they will get completely absorbed. So in order to understand this problem, let's picturize what he is saying. Let this is the sun, and this sun is emitting radiation, and there are particles in the solar system, and when these radiations hit these particles, they exert momentum or they transfer momentum to these particles. Clear? Then the amount of force experienced by these particles, and this force will be corresponding to certain area, so these particles will experience certain pressure. So if we want to write it mathematically, we can write that this radiation pressure is equal to the force experienced by these small particles divided by the corresponding area. Clear? Now we can write this force as dp by dt, that is the momentum transferred per second per unit area. Clear? Now we also know that this momentum corresponding to photon, we can write it as P is the momentum corresponding to photon, is equal to E, the energy corresponding to photon, and C is the speed of light. Clear? So from here we can write this radiation pressure, and we are assuming that the photons are not rebounding, so instead of dp, I am writing P divided by A, and the corresponding interval of time is say T. Now from this result, P is equal to EC, I can write this radiation pressure equal to E by C into T. Clear? Now this is energy, E is energy, T is time, and we can write this E by T as power, energy per second. This is power per unit area, and this is the C, speed of light. Now we can write this P by A. We know that the power per unit area corresponding to the area A in which the energy is flowing, we can write this as intensity. Power per unit area as intensity divided by this C. So finally we get this radiation pressure. Formula for the radiation pressure, we have this PR is equal to I by C. Now from this question, what is given? Given that the total power radiated from the sun is given by this L solar. This is the symbol for solar. And find an expression for the radiation pressure at a distance r from the sun. So what we have to find out? We have to find out this radiation pressure, which is responsible for cleaning the inner solar system. So in order to get this radiation pressure, we have to substitute this value of I. And what is I? I is power per unit area. And in the question, the power is given as this L with the symbol L. So from here we can write this radiation pressure as L solar, clear, where L is representing the total power radiated by the sun, divided by the area. So this sun is radiating power around it. So consider this sphere, it is emitting, consider the sun to be a point source, so it is emitting radiation in the space around it. So this area, we can write this as 4 pi r square, where r is the distance, and this c. So this is our answer to the first part of the question, in which he is asking the radiation pressure. Clear? Now in the second part, he is asking, assuming that the particle has density rho on which the radiations are falling, derive an expression for the ratio of the radiation, F radiation by the F gravity, in terms of L, mass of the sun, and the density of the particle, particle radius, and the quality factor. So this F radiation is the force exerted by radiation, and this F gravity is the force corresponding to the gravitational attraction. So in this second part, we can write this density of the particles on which the radiations are falling. So density is m, mass per unit volume of the particles, assuming them to be spherical. Clear? So from here we can write the mass of a given particle as 4 by 3 pi rho r cube. So this is the mass of the particle. Now in order to calculate the force of gravity that is acting on this particle due to the sun, so using Newton's law of gravitation, we can write g mass of the sun, mass of the particle, divided by the separation between them and its square. So from here we can write g m solar, mass is 4 by 3 pi rho r cube divided by r square. Clear? And in order to find this force due to the radiation, so that we can write P, which is given here, this is given, this force of radiation or corresponding to radiation is P Q pi r square. Now this P here is the radiation pressure, and that we have calculated in the previous result, and that is L solar divided by C into 4 pi r square into Q pi r square, and if we solve it, we will get L solar Q r square divided by C into 4 capital R square. So this is the force corresponding to the radiation, and this is the force corresponding to gravity. Now we have to calculate the ratio. So we can write this as F radiation divided by F gravity, and if we substitute the values, we will get 3 L solar divided by 16 pi G C mass of the sun, density into R, and Q in the numerator. Clear? So this is the answer to part 2 of the problem. Clear? Now in third part of the problem, what he is saying, the quality factor is given by one of the following: if R, the size of the particle, is very much less than the wavelength of the solar radiation, then Q is almost equal to R by lambda whole square. And in the second condition, if the size of the particle is approximately that of the wavelength of the radiation, then Q is almost 1. And if the size of the particle is very much greater than the wavelength of the light, then Q should be equal to 1. Now considering the three possible particle sizes, these three possible particle sizes, which is most likely to be blown away by the solar radiation pressure. Now, first of all, we have to concentrate on the condition under which the particles will be blown away. And the condition is that when the force corresponding to the radiation becomes greater than the force corresponding to the gravitational attraction. Clear? So you can picturize this situation. So this is the sun, this is the particle, and the sun is exerting gravitational force on it in this direction. This is the direction of gravitational force, and the force corresponding to the radiation is this. So if this force becomes greater than this force, only then this particle will move away, or it will get blown away. Or we can say that this ratio F radiation divided by F gravitation must be greater than 1, that we have calculated here, means this ratio must be greater than 1. Now if you observe this ratio carefully, the first thing we can observe from this ratio is that this ratio is independent of R. If the particle is blown away anyway, clear, then the blowing of particle away from the sun does not depend upon the distance of the particle from the sun. Now let's first write this ratio in a simpler manner. This is the ratio F radiation to the F gravitation, and this is equal to, and I am taking this factor as some constant, say let this is K, and we have this Q. Now let's focus on these three conditions. So I am considering this situation first, where the size of the particle is very large. Size of the particle is very large in comparison to the radiation, wavelength of the radiation. This is R very much greater than lambda. And if we consider this situation, it is given that Q is equal to 1. This Q is equal to 1, and under this condition, this ratio F radiation to the F gravitation is inversely proportional to R. This means the smaller the size of the particle, more likely it will be blown away. Smaller the size of the particle. And under the condition when R is very much less than lambda, means the size of the particle is very much less than the wavelength of the radiation, under this condition, this ratio FR by FGR is equal to K, and substituting this value of Q, taking Q is approximately equal to R by lambda whole square. So from here you can write R by lambda whole square divided by QR. So from here you can see that this F radiation to F gravitation, considering other variables to be constant, so this ratio is proportional to R. Means larger the size of the particles, larger the size of the particles, more likely they are blown away from the sun. Now if we consider this situation where R is almost lambda, and in such situation Q is almost 1. So if the density of the particle in such a situation is very small, then this ratio is greater than 1 under this condition. So the particles that are most likely to be blown away comes under this category when R is almost equal to lambda. So these particles are most likely to be blown away that are almost of the size of the wavelength of the radiation. This is the situation for very small particles. This is the situation for very large particles. So the particles of intermediate size that are of the size corresponding to the wavelength of the radiation, they are most likely to be blown away. Clear? Or we can explain this result as, if you see this carefully, now this is saying that R is very much greater than lambda, and under this condition this ratio comes out to be proportional to 1 by R. So this says that if the size of the particle is smaller, if the size of the particle is small, means if we start decreasing R, if we start decreasing R, now this decrease in R will tend to lambda, because here it is given that R is very much greater than lambda, and if we have to find the likelihood of the particle to be blown away, in this condition R must be less, or R should be less. Now when R should be less means, or if you can say that if we start decreasing this R, this decrease in R will lead to the size corresponding to lambda. Similarly here this ratio is proportional to R, and here he is saying that R is very much less than lambda, so the likelihood of the particle to be blown away in this condition is that R should increase. If the size of the particle is increasing or keeps on increasing, now this ratio tells us that such particles are more likely to be blown away. Now if this R increases, this R increases, so this again tends to lambda, means the size will move towards lambda. So ultimately the particles which are more likely to be blown away will satisfy this condition in which R is approachable to lambda. Clear?